Hallo, Seven Motorsport hier. Hello, welcome back to my channel. I'm here today with another episode of Which One is Faster. And I will be driving another A-class car, which is completely stock. And today's car is the Chevrolet Grand Sport Fast and Furious Edition. And like usual, I have five laps at the Virginia International Raceway South Circuit. Alright, so let's get going. I do like to mention that I did turn on traction control and stability management. I found that some of these cars can be a little tricky to drive since they're all stock. And I found this one right here to be the most challenging so far. So for this first lap I'm going to take it easy since it's from a standing start anyway. So that the tires can warm up and I can get used to the car. And starting in this one I will be adding the PI level of the cars at that leaderboard I have at the end of my videos. And the reason for doing so is that the last car I used, the Auto Union Type D, actually had a PI level of 603, and it beat another car, the Aston Martin V12 Zagato, which has a PI level of 622, as we start our first flying lap here. But anyway, I'm curious if lower PI'd cars can beat higher ones. So let's find out. So for this first flying lap, I'm just going to set a banker lap, not braking too late, and I will be trying to get faster lap times in the next few laps. Alright, halfway through lap 2 already. Alright, we're coming up on the left hand kink on the top of the hill here, where I had a few problems with some of the other cars. But with this car I didn't have any problems with it whatsoever. As we turn in to the last corner back onto the long straight, and we're about to find out what my lap time is. And it's a 1 minute 17.5, but surely I can improve on this time. So now that I have set a banker time or lap, I will now try to brake a little bit later and see if I can get some faster lap times. Alright, it's time for that nice twisty section again. Get that first corner right and then the rest will be okay as well. But if you get that first turn right, then you can kiss your lap time goodbye. As I slightly lock up in that hairpin there. Like I said in one of the other videos, it does seem that these cars, when they're completely stock, are easier to lock up the brakes than tuned cars are. So that's lap 3 just about done, and it's a 1 minute 16.9, so that's 6 tenths faster than my previous lap. But let's see if I can improve it even further. I found that when going through these slow corners, that if you add just a little bit of throttle, that will help it prevent from sliding the car. If you remember my first few videos in this series, you will notice that I was sliding around in the slow corners a lot. Especially in this hairpin right here. But as you can see, I've added just a little bit of throttle, and that helps a lot in the car's handling. So the final two corners before coming back up to the main straight in this second to last lap. So let's find out what the lap time is. It's say 1:16.3, that's another 6 tenths faster than my previous lap. So the final lap, so let's see, as I go slightly right here, let's see if I can improve my lap time even further. And yet again we're coming up to the twisty section, where in this video at least I get my braking right. This wasn't always the case in my previous videos in this series. But I'll have to admit that traction control and stability management does help a lot in this. So just a few more corners until these 5 laps are done. So if you have any suggestions on which car to drive in the future, feel free to leave a comment below. So the final lap is about done, and that's a 1:15.9. And it's also the end of the video, so thank you very much for watching. Be sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.